Servicing and repairing these small carburetors can be a little bit tricky, but in today's video, I'm going to demystify that for you. We're going to disassemble, service, reassemble and tune the barrel type carburetor, which is the most common type you're going to find both on 2- and 4-stroke handheld residential equipment. And it's much better to save the original engine manufacturer's carburetor rather than purchasing a copy online, because the chances are you're going to end up with more problems than you solve. So let's get into a top-down view and I'll show you just how easy it is to service and rebuild one of these at home without any specialist tools. So the first thing we're going to do is pressure test the fuel pump side of the carburetor. And what that will do is test whether the fuel line has any cracks in it, whether the inlet barb is sealed properly to the body of the carburetor. It will test the fuel pump gasket and also the needle on the metering side. Now I've got a little hand pump here, but a bicycle pump is going to be absolutely fine. And we'll go to around about 7 psi. And we'll just hold it there for a few seconds and just see if that needle drops. You can obviously spray soapy water if you find that it is dropping to locate the leak, but this one's holding just fine. To disassemble the carb, it's really easy. It's just these 4 screws on here, and I'm going to use a little impact driver to speed the process up. Then your cover plate for your purge will come off, then the actual purging system itself. And the last part that will come off is your metering and your fuel pump side. I'll take that off in one and I'll put the body to one side. Let's start with the fuel pump side first. The fuel pump works off of pressure and vacuum pulses from the piston moving up and down in the engine. And you'll often find there'll either be a drilling in the carburetor body, or on other carbs, it will be a barb that connects to the cylinder or the crankcase itself. Let's just quickly take away the metering gasket and diaphragm, and we'll take away the fuel pump gasket. That was what we were testing when we pressure tested the carburetor a minute ago. That leaves us with the fuel pump diaphragm. Now, as pressure occurs and vacuum occurs, it will actually flex this part of the diaphragm up and down. And as you have a vacuum occurring and it will draw this diaphragm up, it will actually pull vacuum through this little hole, because that and that chamber are connected under here, and it will draw this little one-way valve up, and then it will draw fuel from the fuel filter through the fuel line, through the barb, through the little mesh screen here, into this hole, up and lift this valve up and make its way into the fuel pump part of the carburetor. Then as that pressure occurs, it will push down on this diaphragm here, and it'll end up pushing that fuel. It will try and go back through this one-way valve, but of course it can't. So therefore, it's going to be pushed through another little drilling here, which I'll show you in a minute, which connects the chamber here to this little drilling, under this valve, and then through this little seat for your needle. Here's a quick demonstration on how that fuel pump actually works. And I'm going to use my breath as if it was the piston going up and down. So the fuel filter and line go into the fuel. And then I'm going to suck on this end and blow back and forth as the impulse would, and you'll see fuel will run up this tube. That's all it's doing. It's just pumping that fuel back and forth, back and forth. So if I take away this diaphragm here, you have the inlet barb, fuel will come up here, through this little screen here, which we'll take out shortly and clean, through that hole, that hole, that hole. Those two holes are connected underneath here. And then fuel will flow through here, through that drilling, and then out there. We do want to check that all of these drillings are nice and clean, so we can clean those out with some brake cleaner, carb cleaner. We'll take this screen out and we'll give that a really good clean. These actually come in the rebuild kit, so I do recommend you just replace them, because they can be quite tricky to see whether they're clear or not. So you want to double check that this little diaphragm is nice and soft and supple. And really importantly, that these two flapper valves, these one-way valves, are actually sealing. What they can do is tend to curl up and away so they don't seal, and also they can get some debris under them so they don't seal as well. So double check that, it will come in the replacement kit. And then the fuel will continue to flow through this little drilling here, and that's going into our metering chamber. There are very few parts in here. We have a needle, a lever, and also a wrist pin that we pivot on, and then we have the little screw in here as well. So let's take those apart. And it's done by just taking this little number one JIS screw out, and they'll all come apart. And again, these will come in the kit. The things we want to check for on this side with our needle, first and foremost, that rubber tip, it's actually nitrile. We want to double check that there's no ring around there, because that will affect how the fuel is metered. And again, this will come in the carb kit, so it's worth replacing it. Now the needle seat, just checking there's no dirt or debris or oxidation. And this one looks excellent. Then we have our metering lever. This can wear, this is another wear item. This diaphragm here has a little nipple and it presses against the tab of this metering lever and that can wear down too. So do replace it if you see that that's wearing. We have a spring that doesn't tend to wear, though oftentimes they do come in a kit. And then the metering pin here can be reused as well. That doesn't tend to wear at all. We have a gasket and a diaphragm, just like the fuel pump side, but this is the metering gasket and metering diaphragm. And what can happen is these can go crispy. And again, when they do go crispy, you're going to find they won't pump fuel efficiently. And also these gaskets can start to fail over time as well, and then it will cause it to suck air. And in the floor of this metering chamber, you have one main drilling here, which houses your main nozzle. And inside that is your main nozzle check valve. We'll test that shortly. And the only other place that fuel can flow is through this drilling here, which ends up coming out of this hole here. And that goes on to your purge system. As you push this purge bulb down, what it does is it shoots fuel through the center of what we call a duckbill valve. If we pop this duckbill valve out, it'll make a bit more sense. So this little one-way valve here will allow fuel to go through the center of this plate, and it'll actually come out of that drilling, and it will go out of this hole on your metering chamber floor through this brass fitting back into your tank. That's your return for your purge. As you lift your thumb back up off that purge bulb, it creates a vacuum. And you're not going to be able to see it on camera, but there's actually a little slot. Where is it? It will be here. There's a little cutout on the inside of this plastic, which comes in through this little hole here. And then if I show you back on the metering chamber plate, what that will do is it will cause vacuum to occur on this little hole, that little hole, and then vacuum to occur in the metering chamber here. That will pull this little diaphragm down. The nipple here will press against the lever that we've just had a look at earlier, and that will hold and lift the needle up, and it will cause a vacuum on the fuel pump side all the way back, all the way through, past the filter, past the barb, and all the way through your fuel line and the fuel filter too. And it will just suck that fuel up. This is a purge bulb. It's not a primer bulb. All it does is it purges air out of your carburetor. And that's how that whole system works. Sometimes these duckbill valves can fail and they can be replaced simply by pulling them out and popping a new one in. On this metering floor with this main nozzle and the check valve, we actually have to test that this is sealing. If this leaks, what it will do is it will allow air to come back into the metering chamber and then you'll start to suck air rather than fuel. So the way we do that again is we'll take our little pressure pump, put these parts to one side. And in this case, I'm using a little rubber bung, but you can just use some fuel line. We'll turn it over, place your fuel line over the top of that valve, and then put some pressure in there with your foot pump, your hand pump, whatever you've got, and it should hold. And again, about 7 psi. This one, though, you can see is actually leaking. Now, that could be one, because it's dry, so we'll put a little bit of fuel on there. Two, there could be debris under it. Or three, it could just be old and it's no longer sealing properly. These can be tapped out very easy from the other side, and you can buy replacements online. They're really affordable and it's easy to do. This one's still leaking, so therefore I would suggest that it needs to be replaced, and that can be easily done, and you can find that part online. So the fuel will flow through that main nozzle, past the check valve, and this is all done off through Venturi, through the vacuum created in the carburetor throat. Fuel will come through the center of this carburetor, and where this body matches this plate here, there's another little hole right there. Fuel will flow through that hole. It will go past the main jet, which meters the fuel, and we'll pop that one out. So on this needle, you're going to have a little O-ring and a washer. You can replace these. They do come in the kit, and that looks like a 3x1 to me. Make sure that if you're not going to use one from the kit, that it is nitrile or Viton, fuel resistant essentially. And we'll double check that this needle, the tip of it, is not damaged or deformed. You can also see if there's any dirt on there and you can clean it off. Just use a soft rag. Don't use any abrasives on there because you will ruin it. And then as the fuel passes that needle there, it's going to run up what looks like a very small little plastic straw as we open the barrel. And that straw is then metered for the last time by another needle, which is our low speed screw up the top here. So by opening that screw or turning it to the left, you're lifting that needle out of the straw and you're allowing more fuel to flow. As you screw that down, you're sealing that straw and you're going to reduce the fuel flow. The needle has a little spring on it and it also has another little O-ring at the bottom. There's our spring. And then inside the bottom, I don't think I'm even going to be able to show you on camera, but inside here, a bit tricky to see, there's another little black O-ring, and that comes in the rebuild kits too. So again, of course, like the other needle, like the high speed needle, double check that the tip is not bent or damaged or dirty. It looks really good to me. The last thing that can wear is actually this barrel itself. And the way it works is the linkage, it can either be a linkage or it can just be a cable, connects on to this part of it here. And as you pull that throttle, it actually pull this barrel round. And what it does is it comes round and lifts up, and it just allows more air and therefore more fuel to be drawn in. If your air filter is not clean, then you'll find that debris can get in here and it can essentially sandblast it. And these can be replaced as well. And the way we do that is take these two screws off the top. They're number two. And then this little plate comes off. And then this top barrel just pops out nice and simply. And this will give us a better view of that little straw I was referring to. And they're replaceable as well. And that really is all that is involved in one of these small carburetors. So putting this carburetor back together, it's so simple. Put a little bit of lubricant on the barrel, that slides in place. We'll align the two screw holes up. We'll put this cover plate back on. The two screws go in. Then we're going to place our needle back in the top. Make sure you don't lose that little spring. The needle's nice and clean, can be replaced. And my preference is to set the height of the needle so that the top of it is just in line with the start of the threads. And I'll show you that with the hand lens shortly. Can you see how the head of that needle is flush with the beginning of those threads? That's where I generally recommend that you start. And then your main needle with your new O-ring and washer on there goes back in. We're going to screw this in till it lightly seats, and then we're going to turn it back 1¼ turns. That's my preference, and that works generally across the board very well. Lightly snug there. Half, 1¼. And now we'll rebuild the metering side components. And there's only about 5 in here. It's really, really simple on these rotary type carburetors. So we have the spring that can go back in there, and then we'll put the pin back through the metering lever. Again, replace that if it's worn. Otherwise, you can normally leave it. And then our needle sits on the end of that lever, just hooks on like that. And now that we've put those new components in there, we want to double check that this metering lever is set correctly, because what can happen is if it's too low or too high, it'll give you too much or too little fuel. At the moment, it's just below the floor of this chamber, so I need to raise that just slightly with a screwdriver, and that's now perfect. That's perfectly set. And then on this side, the gasket goes down first, like that, and then your new metering diaphragm that goes on top. And then our purge plate that we've cleaned out those two drillings, and if you need to replace that duckbill valve, you can do. That then goes on top, like so. And then our new purge bulb. You can test them by pushing them against your skin. If they pop up like that, typically they're either on, yeah, this one's got a crack on it, you can see. There we go. It's just cracked on me, so do replace them. That one's gonna go back for now. I'm not planning on using this carburetor because that main nozzle is leaking. And I'll tell you what, let's put that plate back on without the screws just to hold everything together. And then we just need to do the fuel pump side that we mentioned originally. So your screen that comes in the kit, that can go back in. Good. And then we'll replace this diaphragm. It comes in a few different types of materials, but just replace it with the one that was on there previously. And the only difference between a 2-stroke and a 4-stroke variation of this carburetor is in a 4-stroke, you'll actually have a little recess here, a little circular recess and a spring. And the reason why that's there, in a 2-stroke, you have both pressure and vacuum pulses that can work the fuel pump. In a 4-stroke, you only have the vacuum, you don't have the pressure pulse. Therefore, that spring acts as the pressure to move that diaphragm and return it. So make sure that's back in place. Your new diaphragm goes on, make sure it's not creased or damaged. Again, this gasket is damaged too, so do replace them. Make sure your spring, if it's present, is there. Place that back on top. And then all we need to do from here is put our 4 screws in. When tuning these carburetors, these are known as dependent carburetors. All the fuel has to flow past the high speed screw first before it can reach the low speed screw. In other carburetors, you'll find that they are an independent type, and therefore you adjust the low speed before the high speed screw. And if you put your carburetor back together and you find it's still not running properly, I've got this video here which is going to talk you through all the different symptoms that can occur and how to adjust the screws and overcome those problems. I cover both the barrel and the butterfly type, and again the independent and dependent designs as well. I hope they help.